Okay, so welcome to e-portfolios from an academic perspective at Sha Tin College. This is an example of a DT template. Essentially, these are all set up on an annual basis with different topic areas on them for each individual year group. The title looks a bit strange, but the viewer that we use doesn't recognise any spaces, so that's why it looks like that. This is the basic template that students are issued with. And then they take it away and they basically personalise it. So, for example, if we have a look at this one. So this is another student's. So they receive this template, they then personalise it as much or as little as they want. The student hasn't done that much on it. But if we have a look at just one of the subject areas here, one of the topics, this is a messenger bag for textiles that the students are using. So they receive this site, this becomes theirs, but the great thing is the embedded presentations on here are adjustable as we go along. So this enables us to, as staff, to adjust these embedded presentations, and it means that we have good consistency over all the teaching groups, because all the resources are exactly the same even if they're updated. So that's quite useful. So I'll just run through some of these. Whole set of instructions that the students can follow. So obviously they're instructed in class as well, but then they have follow-up instructions on here. And it breaks it down into different little tasks. Nice and straightforward, there's little links on there as well. So I'll just flick through those. And these relate to, LOs are learning objectives, which relate to different presentations that the students are required to produce on different areas of the project. Okay, so there's a range of things in there, also some extension work in there as well, so that's quite nice. And then the students respond to that by creating the individual presentations, and then they fill them in. Now I'll just go to another one here, which is photon factor. This is a lamp project that they've all just completed, so in a similar way, different range of instructions in there, showing them what to do. Right, I'll come back to this section in a moment. This is the assessment section. A little bit further down, they are required to produce different presentations for different areas of the project. So they respond to that in the best way that they like. They can put any form of media on there. So that works quite nice. And it's also nice and easy for them to present as well, which is good. So they go through the project step by step, producing different bits of sketch work, different bits of design work and modelling. Once we've actually done the project, they are then asked to select what they would describe as the best work that they have, an example of it, for different areas of assessment. So we have designing, making and communication. So wherever they think they've done their best job, they actually bring this right to the top. We describe it as bringing it to the top. So when we have that in there like that, what we do is then have a one-to-one with the student and go through an assessment process. Now, the assessment process that we use, all the learning statements are on here. The students are all aware. This is, bear in mind, this is the actual student's site, so everything is actually on here. These are the learning statements that we use. So that's quite useful for them, so they can reflect on that and they can see what they need to do to gain the next level. I realise this is not MIP. This is basically an abbreviation of British National Curriculum Style. Okay, so that's that little job. Also, we do ask the students to create their folder structures, which are all added into here as well, so we embed them onto their actual site. So in this particular page here, it gives us an opportunity for the student to put their entire folder in there. That means that we can click on any of these folders and find out any individual files. It's also useful for the students to get used to good file management as well, so that's quite useful. So this is an academic style portfolio. Other areas of the school use similar ones in different ways. We chose to put all our resources direct to the student on their own portfolio, so that it means that they can then refer back to it. They only have one place to go to, and we communicate to their site directly via the instructions presentations, which is quite useful. And as a group of staff, we all have access to those instructions, so we can change them, which is quite useful. So this gets developed year on year. We're in, I think, about fifth year of doing this now. It's quite successful. The kids seem to like it. And the great thing is that they have a repeatable resource that they can then reflect back on. So if, for example, in conversation, when we're talking to them about another project, we can refer back to a project they did in the previous year and say, right, do you remember that? Yeah, okay, go and have a quick look on your site, and they can find it. So it's good for prompting further discussion as well. Okay.